Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to BBC Television Centre and welcome to the fight. Tonight you will witness an extraordinary boxing match between two celebrities who until 6 weeks ago had never set foot in a boxing ring. Let me introduce you to our first fighter tonight. In the red corner, comedian and star of the hit BBC Two series The Office, Mr. Ricky Gervais. Ricky is aged 41, weighs 13 stone 7 pounds, 5 foot 8 with a waist of 37 inches and a reach of 69 inches. And facing Ricky tonight in the blue corner is entrepreneur Grant Bovey. Grant is 41, weighs 11 stone 6 pounds, is 5 foot 10, has a 32 inch waist and a 73 inch reach. Ladies and gentlemen, let me assure you that the fight is for real. Both of our boxers have been pushed to their absolute physical and mental limits these last 6 weeks. Unless you should doubt me, take a look at this sequence. Tonight, in this ring, Ricky and Grant will meet for the first time since their training began. Ever since they agreed to take part in this charity boxing match, our cameras have been following them. And like many a good story, it starts with a visit to the doctors.
Why am I doing the show? Bit of a laugh, really. Bit of a challenge. Get me fit. No, I won't punch. I won't punch him in anger. I'm going to try and learn the technique. I'm going to, come out, I'm going to get my range, I'm going to jab, find the distance, and then jump on him. Go mental, like that.
You look a bit tired after...
Yeah, see, you never have to do anything that hard in a boxing match. They only do one or two punches at a time. I did about, I don't know if you counted it, but about 40. So, it won't be as hard as that. It's good to have an excuse to do something, like training, because just like anything really, if you can stop at any time, if you do 10 press-ups, I make lists of things I'm going to do at night, thinking I'll definitely get fit tomorrow, and you never do it, but this way I've got to do it, so for 1 month I've actually got to get up at 5:30, eat a raw egg, and then run through the streets of Philadelphia. No, I do actually feel a bit ill today. I don't know if it's psychosomatic, but I've had a couple of paracetamol and a Broca. Will that show up on the drugs test? But, they didn't do anything. You can't fail a medical, can you? You've got to be dying to fail a medical. Here we are. Some of the fans have come up to see me. Hi. Oh. Cheers. Oh, I was going to say Rocky Gervais. Rocky Gervais. Similar. All right.
As Ricky goes in for his fondlings and proddings, Grant is still en route.
Well, Anthea thinks I'm absolutely start raving bananas. Because to actually voluntarily put yourself in a boxing ring, not only with Ricky Gervais, which is a fearsome prospect in itself, but to actually put yourself in the ring with sparring partners and people who are actually trying to, knock the stuffing out of you, she thinks I'm absolutely mad. And if I think about it too long, I'd probably agree with her. Ricky Gervais, obviously, is a comedian by nature. I'm sure there will be some funny sides to the fight, but I'm led to believe he's actually taking the training and the fight very seriously. And I think you have to. I think we can. There's a certain amount of larking around in the preparation. But I think when that bell goes on the night, I think you want to win. And if you don't want to win, then I don't think you should do it. I think that's very important.
He was going perfect, excellent. But, then he looks above the waist. That's the sort of jokes I can do. All right? Is that all I have to do? That's great. Yeah. If that's it, that's fine. Maybe they just put those together and go, well, look, Gervais won on points. His urine was brilliant.
Grant arrives with a sports satchel full of urine samples.
God, big day.
And meanwhile, Ricky gets himself kitted up.
I want the most expensive of everything because the BBC are paying. All right?
No problem yet.
Yeah. Okay.
Protector.
I don't know if that means there or... Oh, is it?
Yeah,
all right,
it's going to be there, yeah.
I need a big one.
Obviously.
Let
me just strap you up.
Yeah. Oh, no. I've seen this in Pulp Fiction. Billiard boy in my mouth next.
Machine.
I've become his gimp. Oh, you're having a laugh. This is impossible. Go on. Do they come in different sizes?
This is there. That's a size.
Oh, is that right? Huh?
Yeah.
Fucking hell. And girdles. What girdles have you got?
They say to you that it has to be 18 ounce gloves, so they are big old gloves.
No, that's so I don't lose them. And that goes up my duffel coat and down the sleeve, just in case they come up in the room.
Remember,
yeah. Oh, yeah. Oh. Now it's a different matter, isn't it?
Yeah, it's a different matter.
Work him out now, boy.
Right. Yeah, that's weird. What's that for?
My cage. My dog.
Yeah.
Protection.
Yeah, I bet.
This the shot
weird. Is. Right. Go on, my first lesson. Go on.
Get him up here. Yeah. That's it. Yeah. When you pass out one there, turn
it with service like this, you like that. Yeah. Good. That's it. Yeah, one, two. That's it. Good. Grant, you better watch this guy. That was about a minute. A minute would be enough. I'm going for the knockout. Lovely.
Yeah.
Just one thing. Have you got something for me to be sick into?
Yeah, got a bucket.
Thanks very much. Cut.
Oh, thank God that was over.
Well, what a medical. I have never, ever been through anything quite like that. I was in there for 3 hours. He examined every inch of my body. It was very humiliating.
Now it's Grant's turn to get himself kitted out.
You must be Denny. How are you?
Yeah.
Grant, Granite, Bovey.
Oh, how are you?
I'm very well. How are you?
I've got a confession to make.
What's that?
I've been in love with your missus for years.
Is that all right? Are we still pals?
You're not going to fight me for that?
No.
I'm a bit worried about my nose. All these boxes I keep here, they've all got flat noses.
Well, not all of them, but I mean, listen...
Have you got a guard that covers my nose?
Oh. Yeah, those boots will shape to your feet.
Yeah, I can feel it. No, that's...
Yeah?
Yeah, that feels good.
Yeah.
What, is this what they do?
Yeah.
Bit of this?
Yeah. You've got, you see, you're a natural.
Oh, natural.
Incredible. Right. That's, see, now, this is very simple to put in the Velcro.
Right.
Save all the lacing up.
Now, is this a sparring glove?
Yeah.
Right.
Yeah.
Danny?
Hello.
What's all this about? What this?
Well, that's for to lose weight, and really, you don't need to. I mean, you're in good shape as it is.
Right. What do you think, Granite Grant? What do you think? Has that got a ring?
As Granite.
Granite Grant.
Granite Grant.
Yeah. What
granite
do you think?
Granite Grant. Yes.
Do you like that?
Yes, I like that. Granite Grant.
Bit like Iron Mike Tyson. Granite Grant Bovey. Yeah.
Yeah. Very good.
So the medicals have been passed and the equipment has been purchased. Both men are now ready to commence their training. So let's introduce you to the professional teams behind each boxer and take a look at the early training sessions. Ricky's team is led by Frank Maloney, the man who guided Lennox Lewis to the undisputed heavyweight championship of the world.
What I know about Ricky Gervais is very little. But looking at him, I mean, you know, he's... Well, he's a little bit smaller than Mike Tyson, probably as heavy as Mike Tyson, I don't think he can fight as well as Mike Tyson. Only time will tell.
Also on Ricky's team is Frank's outspoken brother, Eugene.
Oh, I'm not even thinking about him getting beat, as me and Frank were talking the weekend. You know, I've seriously mean, for Ricky to lose the fight, he's going to have to be on the canvas and counted out.
Yeah.
And so it's time for the training to begin.
First, this is the ring, which is the most important part,
right,
where you actually can take the place of your fight. You're going to learn to control the ring,
yeah,
okay, with the jab and your footwork,
yeah,
what we've just been doing, three rounds of that. Okay. Once you do that, once we master that, the basics, Grant Bovey, be like taking sweets from a baby. We put these on.
So I like this bit.
So you don't blister your hand when you're sparring, when you hit the bag, yeah. Knuckles.
Don't you have to put those little bits of tape on and go, you're the champ, and I'd go,
right. You're the champ, we'll do that.
Yeah, okay.
But until then, you're the chump, so okay. We're doing it the other way.
I've got looks to lose.
Who told you that? It must have been your mother. She's the one who told me.
These are soaking wet. Has someone just taken these off?
Yes, so you haven't bought your own, you've got to suffer. We're kind up the boxing gym.
Can I have a new jock strap?
We share things. Did you bring your own one?
No.
You want one? I think all the boys up there would be too big for you.
That feels so weird. That feels like I'm not making a fist.
You will.
I don't think it's me fighting Bovey. I think it's him fighting Bovey's manager. That's what it comes down to, isn't it? Professional pride. You see, we've got nothing to lose. We're just a couple of idiots doing it for charity. This means a lot to you, doesn't it? Yeah.
Okay. Don't worry about this at the moment. No, don't worry about the right hand. Yeah. We get to that in another week. Just concentrate on that jab. You move a little bit as well.
What, you feel the power already?
Too much power. Relax. You're not relaxing enough. Same thing, but just look, just touch the leg. Look. Yeah. Just touch the leg. That's it, see? If you relax, your power's even better. That's a good shot. Move up, hold it, and out. And again. Move around as well, don't just stand there.
Yeah.
It's odd the way, you want to stay here for another 2 hours, don't you?
Oh, come on.
Training Grant is Mr. Jim McDonnell, former European featherweight champion and the man who famously ended Barry McGuigan's career. He's now one of the most respected coaches in the country, training Danny Williams, the current British and Commonwealth heavyweight champion.
Mr. Bovey, I would say, would probably, with the man in the street, would probably be on a good, you know, decent fitness level. In a professional world that I live in, like Danny Williams, the Tackaloos, then I would say right at the bottom of the scale.
It's Grant's first day of training.
I'm not really nervous, but I am very inquisitive. I have this sneaky feeling that it's very much in everyone's interest to see me in a lot of pain today. But we'll see, here goes.
What we're going to do today is just do an assessment of basically where you're at.
Right.
And where we want to go. This will be quite difficult and quite strenuous, but it's all part of building up the mental strength that is going to be needed. It's also part of the formula that I believe that will not only make you participate in what you're going to participate, but also make sure that you're victorious,
right.
Which none of us want to finish second. So today's just the beginning of a journey which will be hard.
Right, let's do it.
That's a very, very cruel man that Grant's ended up with, isn't it?
25, yeah. 26, 27, 28, 30, 32, 34, 6, 7, 8, 9, 100. Make a fist. That comes all. No problems.
Just try and hit me with a jab. Just try and hit me. You won't hit me, but
I don't want to hurt you.
Thank you very much. All I'm going to do, I'm just going to touch and mess around. But all what you do is get your balance.
You want me to try and hit you, really?
Yeah.
Are you sure?
All positive. Good. Okay. I'm just going to show you to disguise the jab.
You're hitting me now.
I don't
want my head gone. Bobby, just hit me.
Good, beautiful. That's good. Right, what are you going to do now?
Yeah.
Just have your hands like that.
No.
Yeah. And then we're going to do sticky boxing position. Just move your feet there like that.
You don't want to hit me.
What I'm getting used to is just feeling contact. When you're gone, then you can do it to me. Good boy. Good. That's good, beautiful. That's good, though. Here, use that feeling. 3, 2, 1, hold up, one on the block, one, and keep running. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, time! Oh, Grant, what are we going to do now? You got a track suit? We're going to do a 3-mile run, right? So all we do... I'm only joking.
At various stages, both Ricky and Grant have questioned their own motives for taking part in the show, but neither of them has ever entertained the idea of actually quitting. Boxing is as much about mental attitude as it is physical strength. And both of them have put every ounce of will and determination that they could into the training.
Change. Come on, change. Put your hands up, this is... Come on, hit him. Come on, keep hitting. Come on. What are you dying on me? We've lost. Oh, my man's quit on me, look.
Open up. Breathe. Just sit there. Just sit there.
Thanks.
What do you want? What am I meant to tell you how I feel now?
You feel good.
To be quite honest, I feel like I look.
Our training is now going to change. Our whole training technique is going to change. We're going to spend more time actually sparring and going in the ring. You might get a bit of blood on your nose, a little fat lip.
You're having a laugh,
aren't you? No, I'm serious. So now, if you want to change your mind, now's the time to do it. Right, so I'm going to introduce you. For the next few weeks, this is going to be your friend or your enemy.
Let's be friends.
His name is Tony.
He's
an ex-pro.
Yeah.
Wasn't very good, so you should be all right in the ring. But he will teach you what it's like to be put under pressure. And then as you improve, we will improve on this sparring.
Okay.
Okay?
Well, let's start with his hands tied behind his back, then.
No, he's going to start hitting you.
Fucking hell. Tony, be nice to him now.
Take your time. Don't worry.
Just relax.
Do you want a grease?
I'm thinking I might have a mistake here.
Could you be nosing me like that?
It's going to go a minute and a half. Sorry, what are we doing?
Boxing.
You're over the last. Are we fighting? Yes. Ready?
Tom, away you go. Nice and light. Go on. Throw your jab. You've got to throw something back. Put some effort in there, because if you mean
no, because it fucking hit me back.
Come on. You can't pay out the puck. Come on. Come on, throw. Put some power in there. There's no power there. Come on. Oh, you can hit him. Come on.
I'll hit you there.
Come on, no, hit him anywhere. Fucking come on.
No.
You don't want to fight into someone while being nice to him. I want you to hurt him. Come on, hit him, Rick. Or I will hit you. Come on, throw!
Well done.
That's good. Come on, Rick, back to the jet. Time. Right. Breathe up, stand up, and walk over here and breathe. Come on, you've got to hit him.
Yeah. Look, he's not hitting me.
I ain't worried about him, I'm worried about you. The other movement is that you're fighting him and hitting you.
Okay, I'll hit him back then.
No, you won't. You get into the shit out of it off. You'll go on the night.
Pull it at the toe. Put one on Ricky and you know then. No,
yes.
Don't put one on me.
Yes.
Put one on him and it'll be enough. It's a serious game. Not play time.
Serious game. Come on, you want to do it? No, we didn't know what made you do this.
I'll be the fucking charity case I have to give $5,000 to.
We'll come and support you.
Time!
Where we go? Can you see from there, Jungle? Step on your jab, Rick. Bring your jab, lean it. Step right. That's better. That's better. Come on. Have a game. Good boy, that's much better. Pressure to get hit.
Right.
Tell you what though, Vic, you can't fuck about them when you throw a
fight. Yeah, but who's letting me? It don't matter. Hey, you know what's his name? The producer, this Bob Mortimer. He said the one thing he never got you, he sparred with a lot of people who've been hitting back.
Yeah, but I'm not going to punch him as hard as I can when his hands
are. Of course you are. You've got to.
I'll do Grant Bovey.
You won't, because what you do in this ring is what you'll do on the night. It's all in the mind.
No,
it is.
To sit now.
Hey, trust me, the reason we're doing this is because we want to win the fight.
But I'm not being rude here, right? See, what I've just seen there, if that was your going to be on the night, honestly, I don't know the other things, but he had to be fucking bad for you.
Yeah, but
honestly,
you've got to realise, well, I know that that man
is
going to hit me. Don't you think that Keys or your fighter's training to beat you?
Tony, when you spar with him, I want him hit. If you get a hold back, I'll get someone else in the ring.
No, I like what he was doing.
I don't give a fuck what you like, it's what I like. Alright?
Fucking hell, man.
Well, you're the one who wants the box. Listen, I can go elsewhere and train a fighter. Yeah. It's going to get harder.
So you've got to realise.
No, there's no realising. You're in the fight business. If you're going to do it, are you going to do it proper or not at all?
I'm going to do it properly.
Right, then you're going to fucking frank. Hit him or he's going to hit you. And if he doesn't hit you, I swear, he'll go out and I'll get someone in who will hit you. Let's go. That's it. So you should throw him in there.
It's all right, it's a little bit apprehensive, as you know, everybody is when they first start off. But the punches that he did connect with were solid, they were well delivered. So. He's just got the mental problems to get over. I think he's worried that if he hits me hard, it's going to rile me and I'm going to start loading up on him. But it's not going to be the case. If you push somebody too hard, he's just going to give up. You know, so I think he's been pushed a little bit too hard as it is. And it's the mindset of this game more than anything else, especially when he's up against another novice. If he doesn't get the mindset right, it doesn't matter how much talent or skill he's learned, that's the one bit that's got to be right.
Grant prepares for his first sparring session.
Okay, second wave, time. Same time, Grant.
It's no different.
Different world, eh? Listen, this is your hardest bit. This is your first bit. This is your hardest bit. Hey, bud.
Got no energy.
No. Hungry, no energy.
Energy's gone.
I'm waiting for another phone.
No energy at all. Gone.
Different world. New experience, you mate. Excellent. Be proud of yourself.
What do you think of that?
Good. Nervous. That's just nervous energy. That's why he's tired as well. He's doing too much work. He needs to be a little bit more confident and just wait and lay off. And keep his head up. He tends to go down like that and hope that nobody hits him. Otherwise, he should go, just drop the knees, and never take your eyes off your opponent. But he'll do it. He'll be all right. Fine.
What do you think? There's only been... that's his second training session.
That's very good. That's excellent. I was sick and fainted my first one. I threw up and had to be carried out, yeah. That was just training. So yeah, you're doing well. Doing good. Yeah.
Do you reckon he's fighting Ricky Gervais? You know Ricky Gervais from the office?
Yeah.
What do you reckon?
Ricky's funny but fat.
Just having a nice cup of tea.
Can you try shoots? Hold. Back a little bit. Back a little bit further. Back a little bit further. Back a little bit further.
And they said, you're going to do some sparring.
Yeah.
I thought, fine.
Yeah.
No big deal.
Yeah.
A minute before I was due to get in the ring,
Someone
flicked a switch.
Yeah.
Gone.
Yeah.
Energy, gone. Nerves, up here. Hey, one of those punches made me dizzy.
Yeah.
I can honestly say, one landed and I... People don't understand.
Yeah.
Hopefully, when they see this, they'll get an appreciation of what Ricky and I are doing.
It's hard.
Can I swear on this?
We'll get out of your system.
Okay, it's hard. It's hard.
Yeah.
It's harder than It's tough, mate.
Our concern, we've seen a steady progress, right?
Okay.
And an improvement in you, right? But there is still that nice bit in you.
Oh.
And that's the one thing we've got to break down.
It's not that I don't like sparring because I'm such a nice man, I don't want to hurt someone. It's that if I hurt him, he might hurt me back.
Yeah. Stop
one
second. See, he called it a fucking
run
and
an
arrow, so I'm sorry. So Grant Bovey's going to hurt you back if you hurt him?
I'm going to knock him out.
Well, what's the difference? We'll knock him out.
Up and down, change the angle straight. Punch up and down. Downstairs and upstairs.
Answer this truthfully. So suppose we go all nice now, we just do press ups, sit ups, and jump up and down and twist around, right? Don't do no hitting.
Yeah.
And then on fight night, very first round, you come out and Bovey, whatever his name is, goes boom, hits you right in the nose, your nose goes both ways, the blood's come out like a fan.
What
will you do? Will you hit him back or you turn around and come to the corner?
I'll hit him back.
How can you hit back if you're not prepared for it?
But wait, hold on, Musin. What about what me and him was doing? Was that
very
rubbish?
Good today? No.
But I don't want it. I don't want it any harder than that because he's
hitting
me.
Oh, it's going to be a lot harder than that.
What,
really?
Bovey?
Of course.
Don't you think he's got pride?
I am tapping.
Of course he's got
pride.
Don't
you think he's got an ego?
I know you are.
Don't you think he's got an ego? Do you think he wants to get beat by a short little fat man?
You're not fighting him.
No, you are.
Time. Stand up. Come on. Bro,
sparring wasn't on the agenda tonight, you weren't the spar.
Every time you clapped and go, oh, ow, if we all went, oh, Ricky, come on, sit down, get him a stool, get us some water. No, seriously, waste of time having it fight night, Rick. It's only your own good that everyone's pushing, yeah?
Look, two hands, come on, keep working. Punch. Don't worry about that, keep punching, come on, keep going.
Come on.
When you walk out of that dressing room on the night, you will sense something you've never sensed. It'll be different to any stage you've stepped
but
on.
But listen, but what I'm saying is, Frank, in a sort of roundabout way, you're not going to change my character in 3 weeks.
No, we're not trying to change
your
character.
What you can do is make me into a boxer who still doesn't like hitting people, but that will.
Keep going. Yes.
This is the bottom line, right? Because this isn't the be all and end all, and I can't walk away from it. And if I walked away from it, I'd live it down. Do you know what I mean? I'd live it down.
It's not the end of the world.
If I lost, I'd live it down. But listen. No, but listen, I know, mate, I know, listen, but listen, right? But what I tried to tell you, and I think I was nervous, spoke to you about it, is that if I break my nose or lose a tooth or get a whack in the eye now, whether it's an accident or not, I'll walk away because I go, it's not worth it.
Ready for you, Jeff? I'm there to throw your head.
But if it happens in the fight, I'll keep fighting.
You wouldn't keep fighting, trust me.
You'd run to the corner.
Once you get hit, you know, like the first time, you know, like the first time you got hit on the nose.
Yeah.
In that ring, you went on the floor because you didn't know what to do.
Okay.
Right.
I've done it now.
No. Yeah. Exactly right. Now I think if you got hit on the nose, you'd be out. You'd know. You're mentally prepared for it.
My grandmother could have done that.
Right on the nose.
You don't go down everyone else. I don't
want to
film your nose.
It's
full of snot.
You seem to think we're pushing you physically. And when I say physically, don't help that. No, sorry, wrong words. Punching wise, making you get used to getting it and fucking hitting back, right? Yeah. You don't like that, right? I understand that. That's not the way you've been brought up, right? That's nice, right? What I'm saying, bottom line, is you've chose to do something, right? Which ain't a nice thing, right? Whatever way you want to look at it, you people say, it's fighting for a living. It's two men, whether it's amateur, professional, in the back streets of a pub, in a toilet, wherever it is, fighting is fighting. There's no way of making fighting look like come dancing.
That's what you're going to get on the night.
Fuck off.
That's what's going to happen.
He's
going to want to win. He's not even trying. He's going to come out and take your fucking head off your shoulders.
Actual fight night, when you do them three rounds, the only thing that will concern everybody around the ring and the judges is the actual fighting, the punches. Who hurts who? Not who looks better, who's got the prettiest shorts on, but who hurts who? Okay. So what Frank's trying to get you to do is, everyone here, is for three rounds, which ain't a long time, it is a long time, but three rounds, and you're talking about 3 weeks down the road, Rick, so you're going to be 60, 70, 80% fitter in 3 weeks' time than you are now.
Come on.
Thank you, Frank.
Make one more round. Come on.
I know what I can do.
I know what you can do. You're doing one more round because on the night you're allowed to do it.
But all you've got to do for three rounds of everything is just punch, don't matter. Punch. Hurt him, punch him. That's what you've got to do it. And if you can't do it, you're going to lose before you get in the ring.
Right, come on. Walk around.
So for 4.5 minutes of your life, you've got a chance of Ricky, laid back, nice guy, go lucky, go happy, help anybody, in a fucking horrible, nasty Ricky for 4.5 minutes.
Okay.
No, honestly, that's the bottom line.
Okay.
And you've got to be able to do that. Otherwise, you, no matter what he says to you, what I say to you, what Tony says to you, there's only one thing that happened. You'll go in there and you'll have to bloody punch at him. Because he ain't going in there just to say, oh, we're doing this attack. So his main ambition is to go in there and punch the light out of you. Do you think his old woman's going to want him in her bed that night if you've punched the granny out of her? Seriously, she'll go away, you little pansy. Learn how to fight before you play. No, it's true. Because I know when I used to fight and I used to get knocked out, my woman never hit me in the fucking ass, never mind the bed. I'm telling you, seriously. And he used to make my fights. That's true, Rick. You've got to look at it the other way.
Are you happy with preparations, Jim?
Yeah, he's been superb all the way through. What I'm pleased about tonight is he's together mentally.
Yeah.
And that's going to be a very important factor. I don't know how Ricky Gervais feels at this stage, but Grant's relaxed, cool, calm, collective, and looking forward to what he's got going to do. So.
Yeah, no, he seems relaxed all day. How are you feeling, Grant?
Yeah, I'm fine.
What's the truth underneath there?
The truth is I'm fine.
Feeling good?
Yeah.
You happy with your preparation?
Yeah.
Will you be glad when it's over?
Yeah, I suppose so.
Are you happy, Eugene?
Couldn't be happier. Couldn't be happier.
What's your final message to Ricky?
Final message, just go out and let the secret unload, what none of you know about.
Friends of Ricky and Grant are gathering ringside. Good evening, Anthea.
Hello.
How are you feeling?
I'm nervous, but that's because I'm his wife.
Okay, and who do you want to win?
Can I come back to you on that one?
Yeah? What's he been like living with these past 6 weeks?
I can honestly say it's consumed our life.
Yeah?
We've eaten, slept, and talked nothing but boxing.
Yeah.
He slept in his mouth guard, his head guard, his guard for other things.
Yeah.
I've not been able to get very near to him.
Mm-hmm.
And I'll be rather glad when this fight's over.
Well, look, I'm going to wish you the best of luck, because they're going to be in the ring in about 5 minutes' time.
Thank you.
Yes, 5 minutes' time. Ricky and Grant will be in the ring. Now, for the winner, there's a prize of £5,000, which they're going to give to the charity of their choice. And let me assure you, ladies and gentlemen, that both fighters are determined to win. In fact, both the fighters and the trainers have put so much effort into these past 6 weeks that for them, losing simply isn't an option.
Rick, come on!
Despite his trainer's harsh words, Ricky is still struggling.
Come on, Rick, don't, none of that!
Oh, breathe, sir! That's it, I'm fucked!
No, you're not! There's no such word! Come on then, come on, dig in! That's it, come on! He's all right, come on, up you get, straight on, come on Rick, that's it, come on, it's a bit of balance, come on, again.
Last team, come on, look.
10, 9, come on, 8, 7, 6, come on, get up, work,
come on, finish this,
come on, time,
no, don't get it wrong,
up you get, come on.
That's good, fucking good. But you can't keep going down. I'm fucked. We know you're fucked.
Listen.
You see where you're lying? That's where Bovey's going to be lying on Monday night.
That eyes will be closed.
You imagine this. Listen, Michael. You imagine for the next 12 months, every time that man appears on television, he'll be having a pop at you if he knocks you out. You've got to suffer that.
Yeah. So, he won't go on telly anymore when you knock him out. Up you get. This comes, son. Come, up you get.
This board, and it says here, next to Jeffrey Archer, Anthea Turner tells a fears for boxer Bovey. Telepresenter Anthea Turner is, and it actually says this, shitting herself about hubby Grant Bovey going into the boxing ring with Ricky Gervais.
But it's not true, Anthea couldn't care less.
I'm just looking forward to a few days where I'm not living, breathing boxing. You know, I've just, because it's doing my head in.
You want a beer, don't you?
Yeah, I want a beer.
What else do you want?
Well, I want a few beers, actually. A few beers and just a couple of days where I'm not thinking about bloody Ricky Gervais would be nice. I'm never going to watch The Office ever again. Ever. Well, this is Takaloo, who I'm sparring with today. And Takaloo is the former WBU light middleweight champion of the world. And he's here to spar.
We're going to have some good fun today. Just don't hit me too hard.
Okay, second wave, fire.
To say I enjoy getting in the ring and going out and trying to hit someone and them hitting me. Yeah, I don't actually enjoy that bit. It has been a journey. I said it would be a journey and it has been. And mentally I've gone to places that I've never been before.
Breathe that fresh air in and breathe that fear out. No fear.
And again.
I know Grant's doing a lot more than me and I know he's a lot fitter. And everything, but I'm hoping he probably isn't used to taking punches or getting into a scrap. It's strange at both at about 40, is he about 40 in it? To go, I'll tell you what, let's have a fight. Let's have a fight. Really hit each other as hard as we can, in the ribs and head. And we go, all right. When? Monday?
Four! Walk away.
Good. He's ready. He's ready.
Jonathan, the fighters are about to come into the ring. Yeah. Who are you here to support?
I'm here for Wiki. Listen to what Andrew had to say, and I know that she's missing Grant's manly touch, but what you don't realise is Ricky supplies the sexual needs, not just for me, but this entire line. And we have all been going without, and we need the heavy-set gypsy boy back in the saddle.
For your sake, I hope he survives, Jonathan.
He's going to do well. How can he not win against a man who quite clearly shaves his chest? A man, or indeed, is he boxing a lady boy?
The fight is on the way to the ring, ladies and gentlemen. The talking is over, the preparation is over. All I can do is wish them both good luck and hand over to the MC for the evening, Mr. Johnny Vaughan.
Thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you very much. Best of all the praise. Best of all the praise. Good evening and welcome to the BBC Television Centre for The Fight. Three 1.5 minute rounds of middle-ish weight boxing for a charity purse of £5,000 and the honour of wearing the WCB, that's World Charity Boxing Belts. Ladies and gentlemen, before they enter the ring, would you show your appreciation for tonight's referee from Dublin, Ireland? He is the former super middleweight champion of the world, a man who successfully defended his belt 7 times, Steve the Celtic Warrior Collins. Steve, very briefly, just for the uninitiated here, what are the rules, Steve?
Well, the rules tonight, first of all, it's going to be the 10-point scoring system. The winner of each round will get 10 points and the loser will get 9 points.
OK, and just explain the point system to the gang.
Well, obviously the guy who lands the most points will hopefully get 10 points, and the guy who doesn't land as many points will be the loser of the round, therefore he'll get 9 points. It's complicated, but, you know.
Thank you very much for that, Steve. It's funny, because you asked me to ask you that question. Real pro. Thank you very much. Steve Collins, ladies and gentlemen. Invited guests, the time has come to meet tonight's brave contenders. In the blue corner, weighing in at 74 kilos, originally from Nottingham, but now he's punching his way out of the mean streets of Godalming, Surrey. Wearing gold trunks with the black trim and trained by former European super featherweight champion Mr. Jim McDonald, would you please welcome Granite Grant Bovey! corner, managed by the sparring siblings Frank and Eugene Maloney of the infamous Fight Factory, weighing in at an unspecified amount, wearing the red trunks with the angelic white trim and hailing from the bad side of Bloomsbury, central London, he is and always will be Ricky Balboa Gervais! Your judges tonight will be former flyweight champion of the world, Mr. Charlie Magri. Former British heavyweight and top promoter of Audley, A Force Harrison, Mr. Jess Harding. And the former European super bantamweight champion, Spencer Oliver. Also on the ringside tonight in the commentary position, the man, the legend, Mr. Reg Gutteridge, ladies and gentlemen. Gentlemen, to the centre of the ring, those about to box, we salute you!
Keep your hands up, protect yourself at all times, and obey my commands at all times, okay? Good.
What do you make of it all? You've seen the training.
All the trimming's over now. I mean, the tension that has gone on this last 10 months has been incredible between these two.
John and Ross's wife.
Red trunks. Yeah, right. Red trunks and Gervais, just for an education.
Going straight in.
Gold top is Bovey. There's no messing about here. I don't think this is going to be a demonstration of the noble art.
Well, I was speaking to the Maloney boys before the fight, and they said Balboa will go for the knockout blow. They say he has got a big punch, and he's not frightened to use it.
I think Bovey takes a good shot, though. He's extremely fit, by the look of it. He's in good shape. Gervais is the slightly more upholstered one. He went for a sensible walk there to take a rest, actually.
I had a word with Steve Collins before the fight. He was just saying that Grant's really worked on the fitness, but Ricky's just been working on boxing, and he thinks over 3 1.5-minute rounds that could be decisive, Reg.
I'm really amazed that, you know, these fellas who don't have to do it for money and are doing it for a very worthwhile charity as well. I mean, I'm amazed that they put so much work in it to train this bloke.
I mean, Grant looks in great form, doesn't he? He really does.
He does.
I mean, I'm not going to comment on another man's body too freely, but he looks ripped, doesn't he? He looks like he's really been training there, Reg.
Yeah, and he's so keen, Bovey, too. I'm not saying Gervais isn't, but he's so keen, and he's only 1.5 minutes these rounds, by the way. Three rounds at 1.5 minutes. To them, it'll be like 10 minutes sometimes. But the tension gets into them right at the start, and that's what becomes tiring, as well as being clumped like that shot. A good right hand punch right on the bell, that one.
Well, it seemed that Ricky was trying to go in there and go right inside him, wasn't he, with a few kind of. Almost going into his body, and he told me before the fight he was going to try and work Grant's body. He looked at one of the photographs of Grant that adorns the BBC Television Centre today, and he said, I'm going to really work on those ribs, John. That's where I'm going to target it, and then I'm going to go in with a knockout.
Yeah, well, you know, one of the great pros said, you work on the body and the head would fall. And it's very true as well, because that weakens them very quickly. But, well, the thing is, wherever the punches land, it's very hard to judge in a way, because a lot of punches being thrown and judging's very subjective.
Listen, how do you feel? All right? All right, actually, you won the first round. Terrific.
Set him up with a jab, double jab right hand, show him the jab, use the right hand. Keep it simple.
Well, that's a view that they don't get at home. Sorry, Joe Guest just stepping in the ring, and Reg and I probably getting the lion's share of a butt cheeks on that particular angle, but we shouldn't really commentate that. What he was trying to do though, as I say, he had that game plan of working the body and then hopefully coming inside for a knockout blow, a big right. Let's see how that plan goes in the second round, shall we? I think Grant's going to rely on fitness, hopefully wear Ricky down and then perhaps produce something.
Second round,
straight in with another jab to the body, Ricky working
bigger,
inside.
Bigger size gloves, of course,
Ricky
pros.
Trying that uppercut there. Getting quite tangled, a little
bit of shoving going on as well now. It's going to become all in wrestling if we're not careful. We don't want two falls in the submission. Oh, it's dream over, right above the commentary position here.
That didn't fall on me. The crowd incensed by that.
No, they don't like that. Steve Collins is a pretty good judge. He'll be a good referee here. He'll just say, calm down a little bit. I don't want any more shoving.
Ricky again, you see, going right underneath, but a bit wrestling. Now he's shoved him down. This is...
Well, we don't count the mandatory eight count here. So he gives him as much time as he can, actually, Steve.
It was another shove, though, there, Reg.
Yeah,
there going on, was it?
Yeah, as I say, we don't want two falls in the submission on this one.
But there's a hungering... I don't know if you saw Bovey's eyes there. There was a hunger in him, Reg.
Absolutely.
He's really... Look at that. He's in the zone, isn't he? Look at that.
Yeah. Oh,
he's focused now. He's focused on one aim. One man, one hope, one vision. Giving away two stone to this bigger fighter.
So there they go again. There's no seeking respite. They're not getting away at all. They've given themselves a breather. They don't want to know about that, do they? It really does.
It does look tired, doesn't it?
We're getting good shots going in, but you expect a bit of thud and blunder at this level, don't we?
They really do, but Grant coming out of that. Right leg buckling a little bit. I don't know if you saw that. Ricky with a lovely blow there to the stomach there, really working the app.
I think Ricky's probably got the more solid punch of the two, but...
I think Bovey's scoring with some, you know.
I think he times it a little bit better. It's a good round.
Reg, I could watch another. It's sad to think this is the last round coming up, Reg.
I'm having trouble scoring this.
Real trouble. With no kind of clear-cut jabs or point scoring things, just quite messy, getting quite tangled up, aren't they?
Yeah,
both fighters content to let their arms get tied up.
They've listened to a lot of the work that's been going on in the gymnasium with the pros teaching them there, aren't they? I mean, they're trying to do their best and follow the instructions all the time.
That's all you got to do is hit him. That's all you got to do, hit him.
Right,
let's see some punches this time. You're getting tired, right? Don't lay on him. That's all you got to do. Throw punches and you win it, right?
Grant, that's why they're singing. You won that round. You won that round. You won a big last round. Double jab, leave that right hand. Start the trap, work on it.
You can't part commit to an event like this.
It's a very hard game, obviously, to train in, and you've got to be a bit brave, too. The old bottle at the finish that decides the contest very often. But these two have got it. He led with the right, got away with it there, Joe.
But is he Grant scoring with these blows? He scores with another blow to the body.
Good punches going on, good punches. I know it's untidy.
One of them has got to do something decisive here to really separate the two fighters.
That's it. Head. Good job they're wearing head guards because look at that there. They caught themselves head on there. It's not batting at all. It's just because they're a bit untidy when they charge in. They're so keen to get in. Oh well, he's hanging on. He's hanging on there a bit, Ricky. But he's taking some thumps around the ribs.
He looks exhausted, doesn't he? And yet there's still something in his locker, you think, as he waves it with another big blow.
Yep.
Grant jabbing away, though. Look, these are all point scorers. Trading blow for blow now, Reg, as they're going into this. Trading blow for blow. Their arms must feel like they're made of lead at the moment, Reg.
Oh, that final bell's going to sound like an orchestra to these two, I tell you, when that rings.
Yeah.
They are tired now, they're entitled to be. The whole tension of the thing.
But for a while there, it was blow to blow, wasn't it, Reg? It really was.
Yeah.
The fatigue setting in. It's like they're wading through mud, the lads, isn't it?
Yeah, we're running out of time here now. There won't be any knockdowns. I'm not surprised with the size of these guys. There it is.
It.
And what a... Just look at the reaction there. It's tremendous.
Well.
And they've done well. I take my hat off to them, I really have. It's not exactly Muhammad Ali and Joe Frazier, but it's damn good to watch.
Oh, pretty it wasn't, but it was so exciting on atmosphere and determination and grit there, Reg. You can't fault the two fighters.
I've seen a lot worse professional championships.
I'm going to be very interested to see how the judges are going to do this one, Reg. I really am.
Ladies and gentlemen, we have a split decision. Judge Charlie Magri scores the fight. Gervais, 28. Bovey, 29. Judge Jess Harding scores 29 for Gervais, 28 for Bovey. Judge Spencer Oliver, his score is 29-28 in favour of Ricky Gervais.
Ricky, I know you're breathless. Any message for your loyal army of fans who turned out tonight? Really, really giving it some. Moving words. Let's not forget the gallant loser tonight, Mr. Grant, man of planet. Ladies and gentlemen, Ricky Angus.
Thing I've ever done in my life.
Yeah.
The hardest, most unpleasant 5 minutes I've ever spent.
He was heavier, he felt heavier than I'd imagined. So that extra weight made a lot of difference.
Yeah.
At one point I let him throw me on the floor because
yeah.
I just thought, there's no point in struggling.
Yeah.
One judge thought I'd won, two thought he'd won.
Yeah.
C'est la vie.
It's too hard, it hurts. I was just trying to punch properly.
I did my best, I tried my best. On the night, I just lost.
You've won £5,000. Who are you going to give it to?
This is the funny bit. I'm not going to give it to Charlie. I'm going to keep it.
Quite right, too.
No, surely you're going to give it towards the training of a McMillan nurse.